What is a company that you would advise people not to buy products from, and why? Seriously, please like and subscribe, and comment something nice for your favorite Reddit slave. Fashion Nova. They have been known to take your money and not send the product you ordered. They will do deals and email you back saying that item is not in stock. When you ask for a refund, they will give you store credit instead. Hearts Ultra Guard. It is a flea oil for cats and dogs. I bought some at the pet store when my cat got a flea infestation years ago. Immediately upon opening, the scent burned my eyes. I put it on anyways and kept an eye on her. She started acting lethargic and eyes watering. I ended up reading some negative reviews online where PR's pets died from this shit. I immediately pulled the plug and gave my cat an aggressive bath. Stuff was not on her more than 2025 minutes, but I still kept an eye on her the rest of the night. After washing out with an hour long bath and good comb through with Dawn dish soap, she was much better, and I ended up going with a different brand I bought online called Cheristin. After a bit more research and some less than fruitful attempts with baths and flea bombs, vowed never to buy Hearts again, and to warn anyone about it I could. Not many of you might need a water heater anytime soon, but absolutely do not call our affordable water heaters and Plumbingo in Southern California. These guys are grade A crooks. A guy came over last Friday to check the leaking water heater at my parents' place. Was told right away that it needed to be replaced and was quoted $3. Took a exclamation mark. After telling them no thanks, they further lowered their estimate to $1.9K and $1.4K. When I told them I'll just pay the $99 service call fee, they took my credit card, and guess what? The fucking criminals charged me $1.4K instead of $99 by Oremi Starco Mayo. Had my bank charger back them, of course, but the whole experience was a real eye-opener. Here is Australia Rumpest about Grillad. I used to love Grillad burgers. Won't eat there anymore. They are complete cunts to staff and franchisees. I knew something was up a couple of years ago. My daughter, whilst at uni, got a casual job there. They insisted on signing her up to a traineeship for a certain something or other. She already had it. Oh. They said let us do the next level up. She was not interested, she was already studying. But it was condition of employment. Every single employee was a trainer of some sort. So they could then pay trainee rates to all staff. She had her 3 trainee managers in 8 weeks, and the turnover was huge because people got hired then pushed down to a trainee rate $5/6 below normal rate. Recently, along with other restaurants who are underpaying staff being caught, Thea have been caught doing even worse to the very people who brought franchisees. What a surprise. Dodgy. Grillad https://www.smh.com. au/business/companies/thee-slowly-strangled-mcgrilled-stereo-wanerless-chopped-ace-buffer-a-christmas-20,191,206-p53-h-html. Weaver Leather. They make horse gear and arborist supplies. They also use threatened to sue mom and pop competitors out of business if they continue to produce their products. They are currently trying to sue Richard Mumford and Climbing Innovations over patent infringement when Richard was granted the patent and they were in it. Piece of crap company, and their gear is not durable at all. Hearts Pet Products. Literally can and will injure and kill your pets. Edit. Man, this got some traction. The danger isn't even just to the flea drops, but also the toys and treats. Hearts victims. Org. There are petitions on change. Org. And many Facebook groups. Sucks. Loot Crate. Go to the Loot Crate subreddit. Company is in chapter 11. They cannot ship their items to customers. I signed up for a subscription in May. I received my May package in September. And then nothing. Fatter as a grand total of one package I have received from them. I wish I had researched before signing up. People cannot even get their refunds half the time. And even people who have successfully cancelled are still getting packages. Absolute nightmare of a company. Edit. sub/r/loot_crate. Epson. I have never felt such hatred for an inanimate object as I have for Epson's printers. Herbalife. Ugg. Ugg is a generic term in Australia, much like shirt. They've been produced by small businesses in Australia for decades, but some jerk copyrighted the name in the US, and it was later bought by Deckers. Now Deckers sues any Australian maker of Uggs who sells them outside Australia, and have a whole campaign pretending they invented them. They even have the audacity to claim other makers of Uggs are selling counterfeit product. Wish. It's pretty obvious why. They sell products for very low prices. Which means very low quality. Mr. Tire. An auto repair chain. Not sure how far their reach is in the USA. They legit stole my car. I went in to have a fuel line repaired. They quoted me almost $2,000 for something that basically needs a band-aid. I said I'd take my business elsewhere. They told me my car was no longer road legal, and they'd call the police if I drove it out of the parking lot. I was 16 and confused. So I left it with orders that no work be done on it. Later that day, me and my dad went and stole it back from their back gravel lot. They'd even managed to figure out the power window on the driver's side didn't roll back up, and had duct taped a trash bag over it. All you had to do was press the button a certain way. My distrust in mechanics nowadays is the only one stronger than my distrust in dentists. United Healthcare. If you have literally any other choice for the health insurance plan you select for yourself or your family, I can almost guarantee that you would be better off to go with that one. Even if the plan specs you are shown with United seem reasonable and fair, they sure as shit wanna be applied that way. I have never seen a health insurance company that more blatantly or openly denies or delays nearly every claim for no reason in ad infinitum than United does. Rant incoming. My apologies in advance to those of you who manage to make it through reading all of my verbal diarrhea in the course of one semester, because the only insurance plan our grad tar program gave us the choice to opt into was with United. I had every single claim my doctor submitted for approved services at the single preferred in a twerk clinic denied after the fact. They claimed they cold no'd process my claims without first knowing if I had any secondary insurance that might theoretically pay my bills for them. I'd say fair enough, except that I'd already filled out the mandatory paperwork saying I did not have any secondary insurance with the university or person online through United's registration website. And every single time I went to the doctor, the customer service rep who asked not able to find a record of Tato in her online system though. So I asked her to update my info and then resubmit all the denied claims. She grudgingly promises to do so. Spring semester comes around and same deal. Tons of returned claims. Same bullshit excuse. I call and do the whole song and dance over the phone again. At the end of the call, they swear blind that Thea have updated their records for me and it won't happen again. Cut to summer semester, where big surprise. They mysteriously lost my paperwork re other sources of health coverage. Only now, I am also getting phone calls and letters telling me my medical bills for the previous fall have gone into collections because the first Karen who promised she would resubmit my claims just never did it. I make yet another phone call. Only this time I also follow up my call with an email to document in writing that so-and-so will refile the rejected claims within 30 days. I also attach a PDF of the form that states I definitely do not have secondary insurance. That worked for a whole 3 weeks, maybe, but then it was time to start the fall semester, and since our plan ran on a university school year schedule instead of a calendar year one, it was like starting all over again. Rejected claims. Emails with read receipts to prove United Reps received my secondary insurance declaration form, and faxed copies for their records as a bonus. This continued to happen for all 4 years of my graduate school program. Eventually, I got a particularly jaded rep to admit over the phone that United policy was to automatically reject the first claim submitted if it was over a certain threshold. Cost-wise, regardless of whether or not it was a valid claim, needing updated info about secondary insurance was a popular reason given for the denied claims. But I also had fellow grad students go through similar issues with denied claims, because United Air needed to confirm the student's current mailing and or email address, so no, they had not moved in years and the university assigned us EDU email addresses that were used the entire time we were students there. She explained that United knew that a certain percentage of patients who had their claims denied initially would not go through the lengthy process to have the claims resubmitted because they lacked the knowledge or free time to appeal it, or they simply gave up due to learned helplessness after having dealt with their customer service team for the same issue previously. United has since been hit with many class action lawsuits, fines, and summary judgments due to their consistent bad faith insurance practices.